Assalamualaikum. Hi, my dear students. How are you all? This is the second lesson for you. First lesson, what we have, what I taught you, what is it? The adventurers in a banyan tree. Okay, it is about the nature. This poem also. Today I am going to teach you one poem. This poem also, it's about nature. Very, very interesting. And this is very, very famous poem. Okay. What is the poem name? Lines Written in Early Spring. Okay. That is the poem name. Who is the author? The famous author, William Wordsworth. We should know about this author, because he writes so many poems about nature. Okay, so here I'm going to tell about William Wordsworth. Just listen. William Wordsworth, the romantic poet, is a romantic poet, was born on 7th April 1770, Cockermouth, Cumberland, England. Okay. He had his education. Where is had his education? At St. John's College, Cambridge. His notable works. What are the works he written? Include lyrical ballads, poems in two volumes, The Exertion, The Prelude, I Wanderly Lonely as a Cloud. These are his works. Okay. He died on 23rd April 1850 in Rydal, Westmoreland, England, at the age of 80. Okay, so it's a description about the author. Okay, they tell about the author. So sometimes they will ask you write a short profile of William Wordsworth. So William Wordsworth is very, very important poet. So in this poem, in this beautiful poem, the famous English poet William Wordsworth described a bitter sweet. What do you mean by bitter sweet? Can you tell? Bitter. Bitter sweet moment. So here in this poem, the meaning is bitter is bad experience. Okay, he is telling is bad experience. So that is the meaning here, bitter experience. So describes a bitter experience. He tries to explain the strong bond between nature and the soul of mankind. So in this poem, what he is explaining in this poem, do you know? He explained the strong bond between the nature and the soul of mankind. Okay, what is explaining? He explained about the nature and the soul of mankind. Let us read and enjoy the poem. Okay, the poet is sitting reclined in a woodland grove, fully satisfied. So what do you mean by reclined? Reclined mean to sit or lie in a relaxed way. So what the poet is doing, he was sitting relaxedly in some place near the nature, okay, near the tree. And then the poet is sitting reclined in a woodland grove, fully satisfied. He was sitting near the tree and he was fully satisfied. Okay, he was very happy to see the nature. What do you mean by grove? Grove means a small group of trees. Grove means a small group of trees. Yeah, small group of trees. Okay, so it's a group of trees. In between, he was sitting and enjoy the nature. Okay, he is attracted by the pleasant sights and sounds of nature. What do you mean that he was attracted by the pleasant sights? So he was seeing the nature, the greeny nature. Okay, what are the sound? Sound means the sounds by making by the birds. Okay, so he was enjoying the nature, at the same time he hearing the sounds of nature. Okay, he can hear the sounds of nature also. So that much of lover of nature. Who? William Wordsworth, the poet. At the same time, unpleasant. So one side he was enjoying and the other side his thought was unpleasant thought is coming. What is it? The bad experience also coming about what? Bad experience about humanity sadden its spirit. Okay, so he was thinking about human beings and he was very very sad. We can see what is sad. He says that nature has linked all human souls including his own. So nature is linked the human souls. Okay, everybody. Okay, not only others, he is also feeling that. Yet he grieves. What do you mean by grieves? Grieves means sad. Okay, what man has made of man. Okay, what man has made of man. So what he is telling about this is the cruelty of man against man. So the man is giving cruelties to another man. Okay, the man giving cruelties to the another man. So this makes the poet very very sad. Okay, that is the meaning. What man has made of man. Okay, the cruelties of man against man makes the poet feel sad. So one side he was very happy seeing the nature and hearing the sounds of nature, and the other side he has a bad experience and thinking of why the humans are very very cruelty to the and other human beings. Okay, he enjoys the nature. So he was enjoying, he loves nature around him. He was sitting near the trees and he was enjoying the nature, the sights of plants. So he was seeing the plants, flowers, beautiful flowers, birds. Okay, so what are the things he is enjoying? Plants, flowers, beautiful flowers, birds fill his heart with thrill. Okay, so he was enjoying the nature and his heart was thrilling. Okay, he sees pleasure everywhere. Okay, he enjoys seeing everywhere, which he thinks he sent from heaven as nature's holy plan. What he was thinking, these are all nature's holy plan. These are all the nature's holy plan. So the heaven is giving this type of pleasures. Okay, he think like that. Even then he says that he has reason to lament. This word is very very often in poems. It will come, lament. What do you mean by lament? Lament means expression of grief or sorrow. So they will tell about the sadness. Okay, their sadness and sorrow, that is lament. So lament about the attitudes of human beings. So here the poet telling about his sadness and sorrow about the attitudes of human beings. Okay, how the human beings are very very cruel. Okay, he is telling the attitude of human beings. So here, so this is the meaning of the poem. Very simple, but again we have to look at the inner meaning also. Okay, the poet. Now, what he was? The poet was in a relaxed and pleasant mood. Okay, when he was at the beginning, he was relaxed and pleasant mood. The poet feels sad thinking about the cruelties of man towards nature. Okay, so the man is giving cruelties to the nature also. Okay, the man giving cruelties to the nature also and his fellow beings. Okay, he is treating the other man cruelly, and also he is also cruelties of nature also. Okay, so the poet feels that thinking about the cruelties of man towards nature and with the fellow human beings. That is the meaning. Okay, the man is crueling to nature and the fellow beings. How does the poet associate himself with nature? So how he is associating with the nature? He linked the human soul to her beauty and serenity. So nature had linked the human soul to her beauty, the nature beauty. Okay, that is the meaning. The cruelties of man against man makes the man makes the poet feel very sad. The sight of the flower moving gently in the breeze makes the poet think that every flower enjoy its existence. So he was enjoying the flower also, how it's moving gently. Okay, if the breeze comes means the flower will move gently. So he was enjoying the sight. Okay, enjoy its existence also. What is nature's holy plan? Nature's holy plan is to provide human beings with beauty. Okay, and what's the nature's holy plan? To provide the human beings with beauty, peace and pleasure. Okay, they have to be in a peace and pleasure way. But man, what he is doing, he is trying to cut down all the trees. He is showing cruelties to the nature also. He is cutting all the trees and loot sand from rivers and build huge factories that pollute the air and water. They are building a huge factory and polluting the air also. Okay, they pollute the air also, not only air, water also. So here in this poem, he is describing about the nature and how the man is cruelty to the nature and the human beings. He is very very sad about the human beings, how they are behaving with the nature and the fellow human beings. Okay, so this is very very simple poem. So you have to read the poem, and if you have any doubt, you can ask me. You have to read about the author also. Author is very very important. Did you understand the poem? Once again, I'll simplify and I'll tell you. The poet was sitting in a sitting in between the trees, and he was enjoying the sights and sounds of nature, and what came to his mind, unpleasant thoughts. Okay, suddenly unpleasant thoughts coming. What the thought is, humanity sadden its spirits. Okay, he says that nature has linked all human souls including his own. So what he was thinking, nature was linked with the human soul. What he grieves, he is think about the man, how they are very very selfish. He enjoys the nature around him. He was enjoying the nature, and he was see the plants, flowers, birds fill his heart with thrill. He sees pleasure everywhere. He enjoys things everywhere. by seeing the nature, which he thinks is sent from heaven. So this happiness and everything is given by the nature. He thought like that. Even then he saw, says that he has reason to lament. Lament means telling about sad things. About the, he was lamenting. He was lamenting about the attitude of human beings. So this is a very, very beautiful poem. Very simple poem only. Learn the poem. If you have any doubt, you can ask me in the ask me through WhatsApp. Okay. Until then, take care. Assalamu alaikum.